to the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. And welcome to the Superdome, a home away from home for the Ragin' Cajuns, as Louisiana-Lafayette meets the Wolfpack of Nevada. And we begin bowl season here in New Orleans. Here comes a blitz. Broadway protected, has a pocket to step up into, fires to the end zone. Then it's a Ragin' Cajun touchdown. C.J. Bates beat man-to-man coverage. And the Cajuns are on the board. To start Louisiana-Lafayette.
Great start for Louisiana-Lafayette. They came out, they did exactly what they needed to do to set the tempo for the game. Just to try to confuse the defense.
Jackson again. He won't get there. A Ragin' Cajun stop on third down.
Well, and Justin Hamilton moved up front. He got some penetration, which you have to do against the option and the dive play. And one of the things Nevada talked about is Louisiana Lafayette is as good as anyone in the country on third down and short.
Elijah McGuire with a cutback. That looks to be good for another first down for the Ragin' Cajuns. Dr. Stover, it would be a long for him this season if he's able to knock it through. It's got the distance, and it is good. Sneaks inside the right upright. So Stover tacks on three, but the Wolfpack get a stop. It's a two-score lead. Play clock down to five. Here comes a blitz. Quarterback draw for Fajardo. He's got room, and he's got a first down and more.
What a great call. Your playbook is limited when you're sitting there at third and eight. You've got a running quarterback. They think you're going to throw it. They rush up the field. They have a blitzer here. They get out of their pass lanes, and Fajardo runs for the first down. This could get them started, Bob. The field, but it's probably going to be a different play.
Belly option, and Fajardo's got nowhere to go. Justin Hamilton brings him down for a loss of about 3.5.
Kristen Ringo and Justin Hamilton, they call him Juice. Those two guys are dominant up front, and when you get penetration against the option, it really is disruptive, and they never got to get back to the line of scrimmage. Two great third down stops by the Ragin' Cajuns.
Fajardo in a straight drop back, buys some time, guns it over the middle. That's the true freshman, Wyatt Dips, to midfield. 36 touchdowns on 48 red zone trips is an excellent percentage. Big third down. Fajardo over the middle. He's got a first down hookup. Losing the football, that was Wyatt Dips. That is a killer for the Wolfpack. The true freshman fumbles at the 11-yard line. And Louisiana Lafayette's got it. Looks like Dominique Tovell came up with the ball.
But once again, you see Brian Polian going to his defense and saying, we're okay. We're moving the ball down on offense. Give us a stop. Keep the field position like it is.
Big catch. Fumble recovered by the defense.
That they're not coming after him. They're going to have a three-man rush and drop eight and try to keep them in front of them.
They'll run a screen out to the edge to Al Riles, and he gets bottled up. Fights for what he can, but at least 4 yards shy of the first down. Daniel Cadona with nearly a 60-yarder the last time he was in this very position, kicking inside the 10-yard line.
They've set up a return.
Not an NFL punt here. What a change of field position this will be for Nevada as they get the break. This is almost like a turnover as Cadona shanks it out of bounds. And the Wolfpack will start inside the 30. They continue to march down the sideline. First and 10 at the 26-yard line. And now they've got field position they couldn't have dreamed of a moment ago. At the 26-yard line, down by 10. Fajardo fakes the end around and keeps it himself. Steps out of bounds at the 11. He bought the fake to Richie Turner. And Fajardo on misdirection with a run of 15.
When someone's stopping the run and chasing the ball as hard as Louisiana-Lafayette, it's a good time for a misdirection play.
Huge play here, third down and goal at the 3. A moment ago, it was first and goal inside the 1, but the false start. Back the Wolfpack up. Fajardo on a sprint down. Looks end zone. Right at the goal line, it's dropped. Richie Turner was looking for a flag. And now Brian Polian's going to have to settle for a field goal. Yeah, that's not a coach wanting to know if you want to grab a beer at the airport on the way out of town.
No, it's not a two-way conversation.
So Brent Zuzo, the field goal kicker, puts it right down the middle, but that's still a bitter pill to swallow for Brian Polian as his team gets to the 1-foot line. But a penalty, and they have to settle for 3. So Zuzo with a Mack Brown 6-iron.
Yes.
That somehow stayed in bounds.
No question.
And they start at the 4-yard line. Broadway with a handoff. Making moves is Elijah McGuire. And he's got a first down out to the 24-yard line. And
up with the 117 left. You've got a couple of timeouts in your pocket. So 117 in college football is forever.
Terrence Broadway can't miss. Gabe Fuselet has another first down for the Raging Cajuns. Only a 3-man rush, so they play coverage. And still, Broadway is chased. Down he goes. It's Brock Hecking. 5.5 sacks on the season now for Hecking, and that absolutely knocks them out of field goal range.
And you used your timeout a few minutes ago. You had 2. Now you're down to 1. So the 10-second runoff becomes a factor.
What should be the final play of the first half? Broadway from midfield. Heaves it to the end zone. Looking for C.J. Bates. It's broken up in the end zone and incomplete. So it will be a touchdown advantage for Louisiana Lafayette. Play action for Broadway. Down the sideline, he's got McGuire. The wheel route works to perfection. And Elijah McGuire with his first big chunk play of the game.
I'm sure you're going to have your opportunities. So kids that are out there, trust your coach.
Broadway off play action. Hit! Did he lose the football? There's a scramble for it. And it looks like Lenny Jones comes up with the loose ball. A strip sack of Terrence Broadway. Lenny Jones gets the takeaway. What a huge play for Nevada.
It's a huge play. Rushes up, Phil. Steps up. Obviously, it's going to be a turnover in my estimation. And they've got field position, and they're moving it now. So Broadway held it a little bit longer than normal.
5-man rush. Fajardo under pressure. He'll be sacked. Darzil Washington drops him for a huge loss. The longest third down conversion today for Nevada was a 3rd and 8. Fajardo out of the pocket, tries to extend the play. Turns the corner, gets down the sideline, and gets walloped in midfield. Did very well to get what he could, actually got within about 3 yards of picking up a first down. And we have an injured player for the Wolfpack back in the offensive backfield. Broadway off play action. Finds a hole in the zone. Up the seam, it's Larry Pettis, the tight end of midfield. Broadway flips it, McGuire wide open. About 11, maybe 12 more, and another first down.
Bob with Colt McCoy and Vince Young and those guys. And then you just have to say, just trust me. Just trust. Coach, I can get it. I can get it. Just trust me. Now this is an important kick.
16 in a row from inside 40 for Hunter Stover. This for a 2-score lead. He's got it. 11:51 to go. And how often has Nevada been in this position, down in the fourth quarter? Can they pull off another comeback? Quarter, although there have been no chunk plays for this Nevada offense today. 46 plays of 20 or more this season. They've got one 20-plus yard play through the first three quarters. And now it's Cody Fajardo, his first fourth quarter opportunity. Quarterback draw. Breaking tackles out to the 40-yard line. That's a gain of close to 15. Either on the Ragin' Cajun sideline. Fajardo, a slant right over the middle. Richie Turner, that's another Wolfpack first down, a gain of 11. Cody Fajardo, here comes a blitz. Wobbly pass, broken up. Corey Trim, perfectly positioned on Wyatt Dempse. And it's a turnover on downs for the Ragin' Cajuns. Third down and four here. Very important opportunity for Nevada. Can they get a stop? They cannot. Wide open. It's Fusilek down the sideline. Patience shown by Terrence Broadway. And Gabe Fusilek eventually came open. And the Ragin' Cajuns are right back in the red zone.
Don't turn it over, Bob. Keep the right to kick.
Broadway floats one down the sideline for McGuire. Incomplete. So it will be a field goal attempt for the Ragin' Cajuns, and still just a little bit of life left for Nevada. Only 35 yards away for Hunter Stover. Play clock winding down. They just get the snap off. And once again, right down the middle is Hunter Stover. And it's a 13-point lead with 4:46 to go. In New Orleans, rooting for Louisiana-Lafayette. Here comes a blitz on third down. The slant to Turner, and now it's fourth and manageable.
Got his eight. Got what he needed. Good job handling the blitz. And it also shows you the confidence of the Ragin' Cajun defense when they continue to blitz and come after him.
Fajardo has his team set quickly on fourth down. Incomplete. Is there a flag? The entire sideline looking for one on the Nevada side. And Brian Polian came firing off the sideline, screaming at the officials, thinking Corey Trim got there early. Instead, it's a turnover on downs.
Really matters in football.
A first down run for Elijah McGuire.
Again, Mark, now 5-yard runs start being 12-yard runs.
Hunter Stover's been perfect today, and he's back inside 40. He's made 19 in a row from inside 40. And the announcer jinx works to perfection. I couldn't have jinxed him worse. As he hooks it to the left with 47 seconds to go. So it's still a 2-touchdown lead for the Ragin' Cajuns.
He was in the game at that time, Bob.
Fajardo, last play. Brought down again. And the Ragin' Cajuns can celebrate another win in the R&L Carriers New Orleans Bowl. Hardware gets handed out here in New Orleans. So long from the Superdome. Back to the studio. And John Saunders.